Welcome. In this video, I want to talk about Wigner semicircle law. So this is the amazing phenomena that large random matrices, I mean, they should be random, but nevertheless, we find a lot of deterministic structure if the size of the matrix is very large. So I hope to convince you via some histograms of random matrices of this amazing phenomenon.
The question is, what is the typical behavior of matrices? Say I'm looking on 8x8 matrices. Okay, I mean, there are already quite a bit of them. And again, there are the very special ones, where all the entries are 1, or all the entries are minus 1. Okay, and of course, they have these very special eigenvalues. So namely, this has 1 eigenvalue 8, and it 7 times it has the eigenvalue 0. And here, of course, it's the other way around, so minus 8 and 0. Those are very special situations and very special eigenvalues. But of course, that's not what we want, but what we want are more generic matrices, where I'm choosing essentially in a random way the entries among plus and minus 1. And I mean, of course, each of those matrices, again, has a very small probability, but now the question is, are there typical features which we see in most of them? Okay, but again, here with this 8, of course, there will now be 8 eigenvalues which are sitting somewhere. So those are the 8 eigenvalues, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, and so on, of this matrix. And in the same way, this matrix has also 8 eigenvalues. At least we already see that typically we don't have multiplicities. So I mean, where I all have the ones, of course, they had multiplicities of the eigenvalues, which is very untypical. It's more typical that you don't see multiplicity, so you have different eigenvalues, but of course they are just sitting somewhere. So I mean, it's not, I mean, of course you could say here are 8 values, here are 8 values, but apart from this, it's not clear what else you could or should say. Good, but the point is that if we are making n bigger, then actually there will be more structure. So namely here, I have a 100x100 matrix, and I'm looking on the 100 eigenvalues of this guy, and I'm drawing the histogram, then you see I'm getting something like this. So this tells me, I mean, I have, I don't know how many, a couple of eigenvalues sitting here, so many here, and so many here. So you see I get a kind of a shape, which already shows some structure. And the point is that if I'm taking another randomly chosen 100x100 matrix with plus and minus ones, I get an eigenvalue distribution which now looks quite close to the other one. So you see there is some structure emerging. So it seems that it, at least for large n, the typical eigenvalue distribution seems to be given by similar shapes. And if we are making n bigger and bigger, these shapes are getting closer and closer. So here I have a 3000x3000 matrix. Randomly generated distribution with plus minus 1 entries. So I have 3000 eigenvalues. This is the histogram of the eigenvalue. So now you see a very nice kind of shape of the eigenvalue distribution. And if you take another randomly chosen matrix, you see essentially the same picture. And this really shows you that there is actually a typical behavior of random matrices. Even though I'm choosing the random matrices in a random way, the eigenvalue distribution is not random anymore. It's always the same distribution. Apart, of course, from exceptional matrices. I still have here 3000x3000 matrices where all the entries are 1. And of course, they have a very different eigenvalue distribution. They have 2,999 zeros and 1,3000 as an eigenvalue, but that's not a typical behavior. If I'm choosing randomly 3,000x3,000 matrix, then I will see this deterministic eigenvalue distribution. Okay, and this is the main result. And of course, you see if n is getting very large, then this histogram approaches a very smooth curve, namely this curve. And so what we are seeing here is essentially that the eigenvalue distribution of random matrices, at least the ones which we considered here, converges for n going to infinity to this shape, which is usually called a semicircle distribution. And because, I mean, this was really the result of Wigner to observe this and also prove this, so this is also called Wigner's semicircle. So that's one of the the first and most basic results in random matrix theory, and this is something which we are going to understand in the next couple of lectures. That's one of the first things which we want to do, namely really to prove this. That's somehow the feature of random matrices, which maybe if you see it for the first time is quite surprising. I mean, after a while you are used to everything and then nothing is so surprising anymore, but I still find it kind of surprising that you are creating a random matrix in a very random way. So your matrix is random, and you're asking a question of the eigenvalues, so the eigenvalue distribution should also be random. It should depend how you created the matrix, but actually it doesn't. You always get the same result.
If you want to see more on this, please have a look on my lecture series on random matrices.